Hello, everybody. Today I am going to be making a spooky old book. And to do this project, I'm going to use an old cigar box that I got at the thrift store for, like, I think $1 or $2. Really, you could make a spooky book out of anything. You could use a cigar box, you could use an old book. This tutorial you can pretty much apply to anything that is rectangular in shape. But I decided to use this cigar box. I thought it would make it fun to, I don't know, use it as a jewelry box, kind of double as that too. But to start out with, what I'm going to do is remove all the hinges and closures and everything from the cigar box and put it to the side and put it on later. It's kind of an extra step to do this. If you've ever done any crafts where you have to unscrew things and take things apart so that you can paint them a little better, it makes them a lot easier to paint and deal with. So it'll be worth it in the long run. So the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and take care of that and remove all The next thing that I'm going to do is I've got this nice ruler here and I'm basically just marking it, you know, every inch, and then I'm drawing it to connect the lines there. It's a little wonky, it's not perfect, I'm not always the best with measurements, but it does give us a couple lines so that way when I put the letters on the book it gives me a little bit of an idea where to place them, because freehand that would just be a disaster. And for the letters, what I'm using is my hot glue gun and a little bit of yarn. So I'm going to spell out the letters. Looking back on doing this project now, I would definitely recommend writing the letters with a pen first, or maybe using a stencil, and then going back instead and gluing on it. I just kind of made the letters with the yarn and the glue gun instead of writing the letters out first. And I think had I done that, that would have helped a lot. So I definitely recommend that to people who want to duplicate this project. So after finishing up the Mod Podge and letting it dry, I am now going to paint it the color that I want to paint it. So when I first started this project, I wanted to do a brown leather book with gold lettering. And then after I finished the book, I thought, okay, this says Book of Shadows. I would think a Book of Shadows should be black and not brown, so I ended up actually going back over this and painting it, but just to kind of give you an example of what it looks like. But honestly, it worked out because it gave it an extra layer of paint on top of the tissue paper, which just kind of reinforced everything and made everything a little bit thicker. So the only thing I lost was time by doing it. And sometimes that happens, you know, I'll put something together and I won't like the color. I won't like something about it. And so I'll have to go back and fix it. But for this, I just decided, yeah, why would a Book of Shadows be brown? It's supposed to be black because shadows are black. I don't know. It just seemed like a better idea. So just keep in mind that I ended up repainting this. Repainting it. Like I said, you can do this book any color you want, whatever you feel like you want to do. And honestly, this is something that can be used really for a technique that can be used for all kinds of stuff. You know, this is obviously done as kind of a Halloween tutorial, but you could do this if you need a, I don't know, a prop for a book. You can do it if you want to, you know, do like a really cool looking story time castle story or anything like that. You just kind of change up some of the colors, but you use the same techniques. So you just kind of put it together until you like it.